I'm Mark Henderson, and I'm from the Department of Internal Medicine. I'm the Associate Dean for Admissions at the UC Davis School of Medicine. Diversity means different things to different people, but I think fundamentally for me, it means that people from different walks of life, with different perspectives, with different upbringings, are brought together in some way. And that each of their contributions are valued, and that they are shared amongst the group, whatever that group is, to make that group stronger. When we have a diverse medical student community or diverse residents, they are able to, one, relate in many ways better to certain cultural communities. And so I think it even goes not maybe goes without saying that sometimes they're able to enhance the care of the patients that we serve. And fundamentally, our mission is to take care of the patients that come through our doors at UC Davis. And I think cultural understanding, linguistic understanding, are all ways in which our students and residents can enhance and make the care of our patients better. Like diversity, if you include people with diverse opinions and diverse backgrounds and diverse perspectives, you are a stronger organization, I believe. But also, when you include groups that are typically marginalized, you bring, you make healthcare more equitable, and you make it, you're able, to me, you deliver healthcare the way it's supposed to be delivered. The project that we first published related to this, the center's work, has to do with the performance of a large group of applicants to medical school in California at the five, at the time, five public California schools, where we compared the performance on two different types of medical school interviews: the traditional interview, which is a long, semi-structured interview over 30 to 45 minutes, usually with a faculty member or a student. We compared that method, if you will, to multiple mini interviews, which are 8 to 10 minute brief encounters, often with an actor and the applicant. And these brief interactions are much more structured and assess different elements of skills that we think are important in medicine, like communication, like teamwork, like receptivity to feedback. And so those two methods are very different ways of assessing candidates. And so we compared over several years how different people performed on the two interview types. Disadvantaged students, those that designated themselves as having an environmental or educational disadvantage, tended to have a harder time with MMI compared to traditional interviews. And I think that probably is explained by the fact that in a traditional interview, you have a little more time to talk and a little less pressure. It's not as, the time pressure isn't quite as great, and I think you have a little bit more of time to tell your personal story, which I think can be quite compelling in many people who have an educational or economic disadvantage in their background. MMI, again, is very rapid. It's very high, it's rapidly paced, and it's a bit more pressure. So I think that you, some of those skills under, under grace under pressure, or performance under pressure, I think may be more highly developed in individuals that are from advantaged backgrounds. Multiple mini interviews, fundamentally to me, are a way to ensure that many different perspectives are represented in the interview process. Specifically, when you have an MMI, 10 different people interact with each candidate. So each of those 10 interviewers or raters, as we call them, has a different perspective, has a different background, brings a different set of observations to that encounter. And so in that way, to me, you're bringing many more, you're bringing diversity of perspective to the process. There's a lot to be desired or improved upon in terms of delivering healthcare that's equitable and reaches all segments of our society. And so in order to reach marginalized and vulnerable communities, often communities of color, often rural communities or communities that are distant from healthcare, they're not able to realize the dream of the wonderful breakthroughs that have occurred in medicine, but also just even basic care. And in order to deliver on that promise, if you will, I think we need to have a workforce that feels very deeply that health equity is something to be strived for every day in what we do, and that we have to, it's a tremendous, there's a lot of tremendous amount of work that needs to be done to achieve health equity. And in order to do that work, which is oftentimes difficult work, you need to be committed in a very deep, fundamental way to want to work on behalf of vulnerable communities, or work in a rural community that has fewer resources. I think that kind of commitment is what's required. And that's why we need to figure out how to bring those different perspectives and backgrounds and students that don't traditionally come to health profession schools, how to encourage them and enable them to join the health workforce so that they can then give back to advance health equity in our communities, our state, and frankly, our nation.